The temptation when you're painting a scene is to include everything that's in your reference photo, or everything that's in front of you if you're painting outside. But today we're going to talk about why it's important to choose what not to include and how that can make your painting so much stronger. The reason simplification is so important is that it helps clarify your message to the viewer. Simplifying makes your scene less confusing to the viewer, and it emphasizes to the viewer what you think is most important and valuable in the scene. And overall, it makes your painting a lot stronger if you can simplify and clarify your message. So today, I'm going to give you three things you can do to simplify your scene. Number one, look for the big shapes in the scene. And this is so important because essentially in painting, you are creating a collection of shapes. And so if you can stop thinking of objects for what they are and start to think of them more as shapes, that's going to be very beneficial for you. If you just look at the different shapes and compare them to each other, you can actually paint and draw more accurately. Remove the naming of objects and start to look at them as shapes. That can be very helpful in simplifying your scene. So one way that we can look for these big shapes is we can squint. Squint at your scene. Squint at your reference photo. Blur out some of that detail. You can also turn your reference photo black and white in your planning stage. Anything you can do to minimize detail and to look for the big shapes and the connections is very helpful. Finding value connections. So what is the large middle value shape? And you can do this if you create a value study where you're separating your lightest values, you're grouping together your middle values, and you're grouping together your dark values. And you're looking for the large connected shapes in each of these value ranges. The next thing you can do to simplify your scene is simplify the background. You know, it's so easy to get consumed with everything that's in the background of your scene. You want to include all those small little details, but what they do is take away or detract from the focal areas of your painting. So let's talk about ways to simplify your background. The first thing is you can cool down your distance. So a warmer color temperature brings things forward. A cooler color temperature pushes things backwards. So if you can focus on using cooler colors in the background of your scene, that will help push your background further back and simplify your background. And a connected thing to cooling down is desaturating. You know, you want less saturation, less brilliant color in the background of your scene than the middle ground and foreground of your scene. So another important aspect of this are your edges in your painting. Sharp edges, texture, and sharp edges bring things forward. Softer edges push things back. By cooling things down, by minimizing the color, and by adding soft edges rather than hard edges in the background of your scene, you are pushing your background further back and simplifying it. And you're letting your audience know that the important things are here in the middle ground and in the foreground. And the last thing about simplifying your background is use less contrast. So contrast is a jump in difference in value. So if you have a really light area and a really dark area right in the background of your painting, your viewer's attention is going right to that area. But we want to keep your viewer's attention in your focal areas, usually in your foreground and your middle ground. So avoid high areas of contrast in your background. Save those areas of contrast for the most important parts of your scene. And the third way to simplify your scene and bring clarity to your scene is to have a focal area. Now, I don't want to just have one area of my painting that gets all the attention. It's okay to have areas of interest around your painting, but having said that, it is helpful to have an area that has a little more interest than other areas. So you're saving your most contrast, your most saturation, these shifts in color for the area of your painting that is the most important. If you can simplify and abstract other areas of your painting and have a little more detail in your focal areas, the key areas of your painting where you want to keep your viewers' attention, that's going to go a long way in simplifying and clarifying your message. So those are my three tips for simplification. Let's recap this really quick. So you want to look for big shapes. You want to find connections in your scene. And we're splitting those shapes into groups of values. Number two, you want to simplify your background. Minimize it. Desaturate the background. Cool it down. Push it back. Use softer edges to the background. And create some depth in your painting and some clarity on what's important in your scene. And then finally, emphasize your focal areas or emphasize the thing that drew you to the scene in the first place. I hope you find these tips helpful in simplifying your scene. Simplification is such a wonderful tool that we have, and when you start to understand what's important to paint and what is not important to paint, your paintings become a lot stronger. And before you go, I wanted to mention, if you haven't checked out my free video lesson, How to Avoid Overworking Your Painting, take a look at it. You can follow the link below. You can get to it in my bio and Instagram. So I've got some really good feedback from this lesson. And this is a video lesson that helps address something that I had to work through quite a bit when I was learning how to paint watercolor. And that is overworking my painting. I talk through 8 different tips to help you avoid overworking your painting. You can follow the link below, take a look at it, and I hope it can help you out as well. So thank you guys for spending some time with me today. I hope that you found this video helpful, and I will see you next time.